So let us assume that this casting has uniform cross section, and let's say A, M is the uniform cross section of casting, and let's say this is HM, the height of casting. So the liquid will fall from this side. In the top gate, you are interested basically that how much time is required to fill this. So we are interested in filling time. Now for this one, if you check this, the discharge equation. Your discharge equation is basically Q equals to what? Area multiplied by velocity. Is same as area of what? Choke area. Velocity is what? Max area. So I will write here max value is equals to the whatever the volume is here that you have to enter. So for this one, we have the idea of the area of cross section is constant, is A, and this one is meter cube per second. So we want rate of change, that is dH by dt. What is dH by dt? Is this rate of change, how fast it will change. Now if I shift dt on this side, if I separate the variable, I will get this one is AC divided by AM. Is my velocity will change or will remain constant all the time? Velocity at this point is constant or is variable? Is always constant, because you have to fill this completely. So velocity is constant, that equals to Vmax multiplied by dt. On the right hand side, we have dh. Now to solve this, we have to integrate this. All these values are constant, so we'll integrate this. When the time is equal to 0, when the time equal to 0, initial level, this HM is also equals to what? 0. At any time t, you have to fill this equals to what? HM. So we can solve this. We have AC into Vmax divided by AM multiplied by t equals to what? HM. So what is the time for filling? It is called as pouring time, is equals to cross-sectional area of mold divided by cross-sectional area of choke divided by Vmax multiplied by HM. That is the height of mold. AM into HM is also called as volume of casting. I will write Vm divided by choke area multiplied by Vmax. If they give the volume directly, you can substitute for volume. You have to take this value equals to what? MMQ. And the bottom unit is what? MMQ per second. So your answer will come in second. The advantage of the top gate is that your liquid is falling from this side. So the velocity is almost constant. So the velocity is maximum. If the velocity is maximum and the velocity in the denominator, is the pouring time is very small. So therefore, it has lowest pouring time. Is it desirable? The lowest pouring time is desirable. And therefore, it is normally preferred for casting of non-ferrous material. Normally preferred for surface area. Naturally, for large surface area, height is minimum. Height is minimum. So normally preferred for large surface area of casting. So these are the three favorable advantages. One of the important thing is that the pouring time is very small. So is, can we achieve unidirectional solidification? So we can achieve uniform, but there are disadvantages also. What is the disadvantage is that the velocity is very large. So the chance of erosion is always there. So chance of erosion, that is the drawback. Then secondly, for the top gate, the height HT is restricted to 200 mm because of erosion chances. Because of erosion chances, the total height HC plus HS is restricted to 200 mm. So in the bottom gate, molten metal will enter from this side. So this one is same as your height of the mold HM. And let's say the cross section area equals to AM of the mold, and let's assume it's constant. So initially the fluid will enter from this side. When the first time it is completely empty, the velocity head will be equals to what? SC plus HT. Now the fluid level will fill up to this point. Now the net available head is equals to what? This value to this value. Then again some liquid will enter. Then the level will change to this one. Then the net head available is this one. This one is point number one and this one is point number two now. So is the head is constant or head is variable? Head is variable. So in bottom gate, the head is variable. So out of this, we will consider any one head. So we will measure the H value, not head, H value, only H value from bottom side. So if this one is H, then what is the value of Z2? It is simply H. So if you apply the Bernoulli equation between 1 and 2, what is P1 value? P1 is 0, V1 is 0, P1 by rho g is 0, open to atmosphere. V1 square is 0, Z1 is HT equals to, P2 is 0. Velocity at that instant I will simply write as V square upon twice g. Velocity at this instant is what? V square upon twice g plus is it equals to h. So what is the velocity at any instant? At any instant, the velocity will be equals to under root of 2 times of g, is it ht minus h. So the discharge is at this instant, the discharge at this instant is area of choke multiplied by velocity. So this equals to ac multiplied by under root of 2 times g multiplied by ht minus h. And this time, that this one, is it taking place in a small time dt. So right now the quantity is what, meter cube per second. Is this height will change, this discharge here is for this one, is m is constant, and what is the change in height is dh. So m multiplied by dh, is it discharge, and this takes place in small time dm. So we can write here am multiplied by dh divided by dt, is it the elemental discharge, is meter cube per second, and this one is same quantity, that is the elemental dq. So we have am multiplied by dh divided by dt equals to under root of 2g, then multiplied by ac, then multiplied by under root of, I have purposefully separated here ht minus h, because I want to what, sorry, integrate this. So is 2g is constant value and ac is constant value, then am is also constant value, so all those value will shift on this side, and this value of under root will shift on this side. So we have variable separation. So we have variable separation of under root of ht minus h multiplied by dh. On the right hand side, I get AC divided by AM. AC divided by AM and then divided by 1 by 2g. So variables are separated. Now we have to integrate this. All these terms are constant. So we will put integration limit here. At time equal to 0, at t is equal to 0, is the value of h is also 0, because the liquid will enter from bottom side, so value of h is 0, and when it completely fill down, your time required is t, that time is the value of h will become hm. So it is known that the integral of dh by root h is what, 2 times root h. We have upper limit equals to what, hm. So on this side we have 2 times under root of ht minus h with lower value equal to what, 0, upper value equal to what, hm, is ac upon am, is under root of 2g, and integral of this one is, I think the minus sign will appear here, because the derivative of this one is minus sign. Now it is correct. Okay, let put the upper value and lower value. So we have minus 1, so this one is multiplied by 2. First you have to put small h equal to what, hm. So this one is ht minus hm. Then you have to put lower value, under root of ht, limits are put up, equals to ac upon am multiplied by root 2 times g multiplied by t. Now this minus sign can be adjusted here, so we have to swap this term. If you swap this term, it will become minus and minus will become plus sign, and therefore the pouring time equals to t equals to, this one is 2 times, this one is 2 times, am will be get multiplied, am will be get multiplied, ac will be get divided, under root 2g will come in denominator, and this term we have to adjust now, is under root of ht minus under root of ht minus h. So that is little bit complicated equation, we will go for special case. Suppose I make this height is back to my original height, so this time is my final value of hm will also becomes the value equals to ht. So this value is as good as ht value. That is a special case. Suppose my casting is such that it has the same height equals to what? The height of ht, which is sc plus hf. In that case, this entire term will be 0. Hf is 0 or ht minus hm is 0? ht minus hm is 0. So we get t equals to, for special case, if the height of the mold hm is same as ht, in that case the second term will be equals to what, 0, because you have to put ht equal to what, hm. In that case, time for filling is 2 times am divided by ac under root of 2 multiplied by root of ht. And suppose if I multiply the numerator by hm and divide at the same time by hm, suppose I multiply by hm and divide by hm, then is hm is same as ht for special case. So I can very well write this hm equals to what, ht, that is bottom only, this is just an adjustment, and therefore am multiplied by hm, is it a volume of mold, and this under root of ht and this ht will become under root of ht. So this is a pure adjustment. So this one is 2 times, is it am multiplied by what, hm, divided by AC under root of 2G, and one of the HT will be adjusted like this. Now what is under root of 2G into HT? So this one is 2. Is it the volume of mold divided by, this is the volume of mold divided by area of choke is under root of 2G HT. Is this equation is same as Vmax, and is this equation is same for, is this equation is same for top gate? So does it mean that the time required for bottom gate is 2 times the time required for top gate? So which one is more efficient? Top gate is more efficient or bottom is more efficient? Top gate always requires 50%, not for all cases, only for special case. Bottom gate, bottom gate for pouring time is more than the top gate. It is desired or is undesired? Undesired. So is, do you have a problem of directional solidification? So there is always a problem. So there is issue with directional solidification. But what is the advantage? Advantage is that the velocity is coming from the bottom side. So the velocity is not going to strike on the sand. So the erosion problem has been solved, eliminated completely. The velocity, the fluid is entering from bottom side, and therefore the erosion is completely avoided. So erosion of sand can be avoided. Only disadvantage is what? Time. That is the basic thing. We are getting these two not for this. Remember this, right? Quick calculation method. You can find out the maximum velocity, Vmax. Is the maximum velocity is equals to, what is the maximum rate? HT. So maximum velocity is under root of 2 multiplied by G multiplied by HT. What is the minimum velocity? The minimum velocity you will get when the head available is this only. So V minimum will be under root of 2 times G multiplied by HT minus HM. Your head available is what? HT minus HM. Now I said it's a quick calculation, it is not a correct method. Correct method is this method. So we can find out V average. This velocity is changing from this point to this point, but actually this method is wrong. Why it is wrong? Because velocity is not changing linearly. Velocity is changing with respect to what? Under root of term. So it's a non-linear equation. But we are considering the linear equation, and we are calculating this value as V max plus V minimum divided by 2. And your value will match very close. Why? Because the height is very small. It's a very, very small height calculations. So linearity can be converted to, non-linearity can be converted to linearity. You can use this equation only when velocity is linear function. That a velocity should go like this, then linear. And velocity will go like this is non-linear. Velocity is a function of what? Under root term. And height is changing. So it's a non-linear actually. Once you get this value, you can find out the pouring time equals to volume of casting divided by choke area multiplied by V average. You can get your answer, and you can use this method if you are given the choice or something like this: 10 second, 20 second, 30 second and 40 second. Then it works fine. But if your answer is given like this: 10, 10.5, 11.5, 11, it's a close match. So for close match, you have to go by this method. The third type of gate is called as parting gate. As the name indicates, it partly the top and partly the bottom. So it has the advantage of the bottom gate as well as advantage of top gate. So total height you have to divide into two parts. This will be HM1, this will be HM2. So if the lower part is filled by, the top gate, and assume that AM is constant, that is uniform cross section. So what is the time required for bottom part? So time required for bottom part is simply AM multiplied by HM2 divided by choke area multiplied by maximum velocity. If the maximum velocity is under root of 2 into G into HT. So what is the time required for bottom gate now? Now remaining fluid will fill from the bottom side. So we have to fill now the top side of the molding by the bottom gate. So for bottom gate we have a formula equals to AM, I think, multiplied by 2 times divided by AC divided by AC divided by AC divided by under root of 2G into bracket under root of HT minus under root of, it's a HT minus, is it HM1 only? Only HM1. Out of HM1 and HM2, which head will give resistance to this molten metal? Only HM1. So that is why HM1. In a sand casting process, a sprue of 15 mm base diameter, base is bottom, and 300 mm height leads to a runner which fills the cubical mole cavity of 150 mm size. So we have a, forget about the part given, type of gate is mentioned or not mentioned. So by default is top gate. So we have a top gate like this. What is the height of the screw given? Height itself is equals to what? HT. HT equal to what? 300 mm. What is the base diameter here? Only one diameter is given, that equals to 15. So are we able to calculate discharge at this point? We can calculate discharge. And what is this casting? Is it a cubical casting? Cubical casting has a side equals to what? 150. So what is the volume of casting? Is it A cube? So what is the velocity? Under root of? Under root 2 times G multiplied by HT. You have to just take a care of G, that's all. Under root of 2 times. G is 9810. If you are not familiar with this conversion, then go by SI unit. Forget about this, like this, doesn't make a difference. Then what is this value? Must be 0.3. So we back to fluid mechanics. This is an easy approach. So what is the velocity? Your velocity is 2.42. Our time required is, volume of casting is what? 0.15 cube. Everything we are considering to what? Meters. Cross section is pi by 4 d square. Corresponding velocity is 2.42. This is a simple fluid problem. A height of the downscrew is 175 mm. And its cross section area at the base is what? 200 mm square. The cross section area of the horizontal runner is also 200. Assuming no losses, indicate the correct choice for the time required to fill a mole cavity of 10 to the power 6. So this time, is the height of basin is given or not given? Not given. So HT is same as, is equal to 175 mm. Area at the base is also 200 and area of runner is also 200. The minimum area is equals to what? Choke area. So choke area is same as 200 mm square. 200. Assuming no losses, indicate, you have to find out actually choice is given here. I have not written the choice. What is the volume of casting? Volume of casting is 10 to the power 6. Mm cube is 10 to the power minus 9. A is meter cube. So we have a very simple formula. T equals to velocity, volume of casting divided by the area of choke multiplied by under root of 2 times G multiplied by total area. Put this value back here and solve for T. I think your answer should come very close to 2.67 seconds. Now this time figure is provided to you. A 200 mm long down screw. So this one is 200 mm long screw. Has an area of cross section 650 mm square where the pouring basin meets. Is this area is 650 mm square? The first part I have taken this one, 650. A constant head of molten metal is maintained by pouring the basin and the molten metal flow rate is what? 6.5 10 to the power 5. So is the discharge at this point is known to us. Now this data is sufficient to find out the missing height of cup by applying the Bernoulli equation at point 1 and at point 2. So let's apply the Bernoulli equation between 1 and 2. Applying Bernoulli between 1 and 2. So we have Bernoulli equation is P1 by rho g plus V1 square by twice g plus Z1 equals to, I am using a P2 value, P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2. So right now what we say is that my Z2 is datum. If Z2 is datum, if Z2, that is this point is datum, then is H1 is same as SC. This side is what? SC. So what is P1? 0. What is the velocity at inlet? 0. What is Z1? SC. P2? 0. Velocity at V2, we don't know. So let's write V2 square by twice G plus Z2. If Z2 is 0. Now this time we are able to find out the value of SC if you know the value of V2. So we have a continuity equation at point number 2. The continuity equation at point number 2 says that Q equals to what? A2 V2. Continuity equation at point number 2 is Q equal to what? A2 V2. Q is given as 6.5, 10 to the power 5 and this one is what? Mm cube. So this one is mm cube. So we have to take area also in mm. Is the area at point 2 is 650 and the velocity at section 2 we can calculate. So I think it's, is it 1000 mm per second? Put this value back here and solve this equation. So we have SC. SC equals to V2 square is 1000 divided by 2. 10 to the power 4. We want the area of the downscrew at this point. So we will call this section equals to what? Point number 3. So we have same equation. Q equal to what? A3 into V3. If you are able to calculate the velocity 3, can we calculate the area at 3? So for this we have two choice. We can consider Bernoulli from 1 to 3. or we can consider Bernoulli from 2 to 3. So we'll consider from 1 to 3. So let apply P1 rho g. So this one is P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is P3 by rho g plus V3 square by 2g plus Z3. Now what is Z3? We'll assign Z3 equal to what? Datum. If Z3 is datum, then will Z1 will be equals to the height of cup plus the height of screw. Okay, what is P1? 0. V1? 0. Z1 is height of cup. Height of cup is 50 plus height of screw 200. What is P3? 0. Is V3 square divided by 2 times 10 to the power 4 that is given to us. Value of Z3 is 0 because of datum. So we can get V3 value. So velocity is 2236 mm. So finally Q equals to what? 6.5 into 10 to the power 5. Area at this one we want to find out into velocity 2236 290 point, we will make it 7. Now remember, one common mistake made by the student is that they will forget the height of cup, because in maximum previous problem we have never used the height of cup, we have only used the height of screw. So he has indirectly given you two force to calculate the height of cup. So basically they want that the student must understand the Bernoulli equation. You cannot neglect the height of cup, because if the data is provided to you, you must try for height of cup, because 50 mm is sufficient quantity as compared to what? 200. It's a 25% contribution.